So download, well, so there's two downloads, you have to be careful here. There's one for x86, so it's 32-bit, and one for 64-bit, so obviously we need this one here. So save link as. Just check we're in source BLFS, we are. So I'll save that. And while that's downloading, because it's probably quite a size, I'll just tidy up here. Let's see how that's going. So just about a couple of minutes or so. Try to get rid of this window. I might have to just leave it down here. Just can see the progress here, even if I can't see what file is downloading. Okay, it's done, so I'll extract it now. Change into it as usual, and then as the root, we run these commands to basically just copy the files which are just extracted into the opt directory, and then create a JDK link to the versioned directory. There you go. So now we've got to move on to configuring the Java environment. So there's profile script here. It says if sudo is installed, the CPU should have access to above variables. So we'll add that in because we've got sudo. And for allowing MandDB to include OpenJDK man pages in the database, issue this as a root user. Setting up the CA certificates for Java. Uses its own format for CA certificates. Java security modules use by default. In order to keep all the certificates in one place, we use etc SSL Java CA certs. The instructions on the make CA page previously creates a file located in etc SSL Java. Set up a symlink in the default location as the root user. Copy that. Is that copied correctly? That looks a bit funny there. Opt JDK lib security certs etc PKI TLS Java. Yeah, it is. Use the following command to check that if the CA certs file has been successfully installed. At the prompt, enter the key store password, enter change it to the default, or just press the enter key. Still in the right window. If the CA certs file is installed correctly, you'll see a list of certificates with the related information for each one. If not, you need to reinstall them. If you later install a new JVM, you just have to recreate the SIM link in the default location to be able to use CA certs. So that's the Java binary that's been installed, but we haven't installed our own copy from source yet. So I'll cross that off. So that's under Java 16.0.2. And we'll go to Apache Ant now. So I'll get this downloading. While that's downloading, I'll tidy this up. Okay, and looks like it's finished downloading. Apache and I'm hoping this will install, even though we haven't got the full dependencies for the Java and the glib, so let's see how this goes. Java home environment. Okay, so what I need to do here is to resource etc profile and rerun that bootstrap. It should work now. Okay, that's done. So now we need to download some runtime dependencies. All good, and then build Apache Ant. That's done. So it looks all successful. As you saw, that was testing. It went through, so it's all good. So install this now. Again, it looks like it's gone into the opt hierarchy, so it could be quite easily updated. Configuration. Add some profile information so that ANC can be found. And that's it. So if I come out of this, ANC probably didn't do anything, but if I resource the profile, it will load that script and ANC should now work. You can see it's trying to build what's in the source again. So I'll tidy that up now. Apache ANC. And that's chapter 13 again. So I'll cross that off, it's complete. And we can close that down. So that was one of the runtimes. It's obviously optional if it's not important to you. But it's just one of the optional runtimes that I've installed. So all the other optional programs are installed that I want to put in. I won't do Ruby, I don't use it, so but you can see how to install these things. So DocBook XSL Nons, let's grab this. So Vincas. There's a patch. And some documentation. So let's extract it. DocBook XSL Nons. So we start with a patch and extract the documentation which we downloaded, and then the rest is done as the root. And we put the documentation into the system as well. And that's done. If you're installing a current version over a previous version, so we're not doing that, so we just need to run this to create an append the XML catalog file. Occasionally you may find the need to install other versions of XSL stylesheets as some projects reference a specific version, and it shows you there how to do that with an example. So that's DocBook XSL Nons, which is chapter 49 again. So I can get rid of that tab now. And I'll tidy up. So that fulfills DocBook XML as I recall. DocBook XSL, so we've done that one. I presume we have, there's no tab for it. Oh yes, that's the one we've just done, isn't it? Of course it is. It's a different name. So let's go back to libxsl2. So all we need to concentrate now is libgcrypt. And this has got libgpg error. Which hasn't got any dependencies. PTH, which needs GCC built with Fortran. And TextLive, or what's this? Okay, so it's like a binary installer with the looks of it. TextLive, right, that's got loads of dependencies. I think I would like to install that as early as I can. But maybe not at the moment. Or do I? Let's have a look at this one. Why does it keep moving? GDB, I think that's for debugging, isn't it? Yeah, I don't think I'll be installing that. Falkon, I won't be installing. ISL is off the book. So that one's going to take maybe a couple of hours. That's what PTH needs. Let's go back to TextLive. It's in a private window. So yeah, GhostScript is a package that needs lots of dependencies. And I bet they spread out a lot. Too many, but I think these will probably spread quite a lot. I think it'll be good to install this because it will be something I'll be doing at some time. LibGPG error, what was that for? Gnome keyring, was it? This is trouble with getting too many tabs open. Let's go back here. XSLT. Oh, right, that needed libgcrypt. Is that what it is? Oh, right, libgpg error. That's where it's from. So it's for this package here. Libgpg error. Hasn't got any dependencies. Right, I think what I'm going to do is try and pick some of these off and get rid of some of these other tabs because there's things dangling around like GnuPG. Let's have a quick look at that one. Look through these backwards. That's got a few dependencies. OpenSSL, that shouldn't, OpenSSH, that shouldn't have any dependencies to speak of. That's for debugging and for tests. Got Linux PAM, we've got an X Windows system, I'm not going to install the rest of them. We've got a Java optional runtime. We need to get that entropy, so that's not a problem. Let's have a look, see how onerous these are. So that hasn't got any dependencies. And neither has that. Okay, so I think we can install these two and get OpenSSH running. And then that will be that part out of the way. Let's have a quick look at this one. If it helps with tests, it might be a good thing. Oh, it's got a few dependencies. That's in trouble. Yeah, I think I will leave that. Okay, yeah, I'm going to do nettools and sysstat. Get those two installed, and then that's OpenSSH done, so that'll be one thing off that Gnome keyring. Designed to be controlled by a cron daemon, okay. Yeah, this might be a good time to install this actually, because it's quite useful to have. There will be other packages that we'll be needing to install scripts for, to be run regularly. An MTA and .book utils. I'm not sure if that's a big download or not. Yeah, getting deeper and deeper again. What does this do? Okay, this sounds like it could be useful. So let's get this loaded as well. So mail server software, the simplest one here is send mail. That needs open LDAP. Cyrus Sazzle. And Ghost Script for creating PDF documentation. Right. I'll probably reinstall this to get that PDF documentation then. And Procmail is something that needs to be installed as well. So open LDAP. Yeah, it's just going around in circles again. Sazzle. Mail. NSL. Two. Okay. Right, this has gone much deeper than I thought it would do, but these are probably going to have to be installed at some point. So, yeah, let's start with this one then and try and work our way back. libtirpc. So we've already done this one. So I'll verify that on my list. Chapter 17. Yep, got it crossed off, so that confirms that. Get rid of that one. Next one is RPC service proto. chapter 17 as well. That's been installed as well, so that's good. Oh yes, I vaguely remember installing these now. I think this one's been done as well. Chapter 17, libnsl, yep, that's done. So procmail, recommend it needs an MTA, which is what we're trying to build, which is what send mail is. Procmail. Right, I think I'll install procmail. When I've installed send mail, I'll reinstall procmail. I think it's probably the best thing to do. Let's do that. So I'm pretty sure I haven't installed this one, chapter 19. Oh yes, I have, it's crossed off. So have I done send mail then? Is that why these are here? Chapter 4. Yes, I've got Sorry Cecil done as well, so it looks like I've done a lot of these. The only thing is, I haven't got the OpenJDK wasn't installed, so I might install that one again. OpenLDAP. This didn't have PTH installed, which I'm going to install again. I can't remember if I've done MariaDB or not, or if that's a rebuild. Chapter 22. Oh yeah, I've got a mark. So I haven't installed MariaDB and it says to reinstall Cyrus Sazzle. Okay. What dependencies did that need? Quite a few there. That Ruby keeps coming up. Right. Tempted to install Ruby now. Okay, let me check send mail then, because that's an important one. Send mail's chapter 21. Yeah, I've installed that as well. Right, so if I install procmail, it's got the MTA. I'm not sure if I've reinstalled it after the MTA or not, so I'm going to reinstall it again to be sure. And then I know for certain it has been installed with the recommendations for certain. So I'll do that. So this has got to be done as the root user. And that looks like that's completed successfully. I imagine this is going to fail. Oh, it did go. Okay. So, Procmail, chapter 19, that's definitely gone. Sorry, Sazzle. So, this needed. Well, let's look at this Barclay DB. I think I did that one as well. Yes, I remember that. Shy Utils, actually. Chapter 22. Barclay DB, yeah, so I'm just going to open this Shy Utils. I know that must have been installed. Chapter 11. Yep, that's installed. That's good. So I'm going to install MariaDB. We've got a JDK install, but not necessarily the open one, so that's not really a problem. I think we've got SQLite installed, actually. Yep, that's installed. So let's just open that in a tab. So MariaDB, quite CMake, which we've got, although that needs a rebuild, should be okay because it's just required to compile. Let's have a look at Libevent. I think this might have been done, possibly. 17. No, okay, we haven't done Libevent. And it's only got one requirement for API documentation, so I'm going to build this one now, I think. Get it. Safe link has. Fix here. Configure and make. Is there any other options? No. So we're not building API documentation. So I'll do some tests when this is finished building. Okay, let's run the tests. Okay, so that has finished testing with complete pass. So as the root user, we'll do an install now. And we can ignore the remaining commands. Ignore the main commands because that's for the API documentation. So that is libevent completed. So chapter 17, libevent, cross that off. So options here, we've got boost. Needs which I'm pretty sure we've installed, so let's check that. 12, yeah, which has been installed. ICU, I'm pretty sure that's been done, so that's chapter 9. And that's got reload after LLVM. So let's see if it's worth doing LLVM now. And that's got CMake. I'm sure CMake had a rebuild against it. Yeah, it has. Let's get CMake up. Alright, and then this is back to GCC. We've got here. I think all these others were installed. So let's find our GCC. Just remind us what that involved. That needed GDB. I've got that up here. GDB. That one now, GDB. Right, there's kind of a circuit dependency here. So what I'm going to do is to put GCC all the way down next to GDB, which is what needed it, yep. And the same, no, it wasn't GDB, was it? Right, now I've forgotten where I was. System tools. Oh yeah, it was all the way down here, wasn't it? It was for CMake, wasn't it? Yeah. So what I shall do is get rid of these two and open them up next to CMake, which is that tab there. Actually, I'll click on these to validate these, to change the links and double check them as well. Chapter 9, General Libraries. LibUV, yeah, that's done. Curl, that's chapter 17. So this needs a rebuild after some of the options have been built. LibArchive, let's try that one. Chapter 9. fine. Archive, yeah, that's got complete against it, so that probably means that LZO and Nettle have been installed fully as well. Let's look at Nettle, yeah, that one's chapter 4. Yeah, that's been crossed off. LZO is chapter 9. There it is. And that's got no dependencies, so yes, the dib archive has been done. So next, nghttp, I'm pretty sure this was installed okay. This is chapter 17. Right, this needs to be reinstalled after options again. So let's move on with the CMake one. Git we need for tests, Mercurial used during tests, Subversion for testing, Qt. Right, let's load these up. Doing Qt as well, even though I know I've got to reinstall it. So let's put these here. So start with Subversion, what does that need? Okay. It just seems endless, this dependency requirements. Looks like I might have to do Ruby. It's because I'm going for the optional, or most of the optional. Okay, let's look at Mercurial. That needs Git. So let's put that there. What does Git need? It needs curl. That's another one that needs to be installed with dependencies. Curl needs nghttp. There. So boost, is that one of the ones that needs to be installed? That required ICU, and ICU needs da-da-da, and it keeps on going round and round the circles. Right, Apache I probably won't install because that's more a server. Yeah, so I won't be installing that. It's not appropriate for a desktop system. Let's take a look at a couple of these. Thing is, if we can get down to a point where you're getting to the packages that don't have dependencies, it makes things a little bit easier. So these two, not quite CMake. That'll probably be for runtime, so that's fine. For runtime, would have thought. To compile it rather than runtime, it's to compile it. So I guess we could install these two. A couple more small packages to get done out of the way. file. So tar.cpf. So this is a straightforward compile. Test it. Looks good. So let's install it. And that's it. So it's chapter 9. It's like the thing about eating an elephant. You just take a little bite at a time and eventually you'll get there. So it's Jansson done. CRS. Okay, looks like we might have already installed that one. So let's check that. That's on chapter 17. Yep, we have. So that's okay. So we're back to ng-http. So we've done a libevent now. So it's really down to boost and what boost requires. And I think this is where I'm going around in circles now, because boost needs ICU. ICU needs LLVM. LLVM needs CMake. Well, we've got it running, so it probably only needs it in that. It needs the binary. But then we're going to CMake requiring all of these. One of which is curl. And ng-http. And there was, yeah, it's getting deep again. I wonder if there's any other small ones we can get out of the way, just little ones to help things along. So Git Mercurial Subversion for testing. GCC for G4tran. Let's have a look at curl. So we've got MakeCA installed. I know that for a fact because we worked hard to get that up and running initially. So I just clicked on that to get that link changed. And normally GNU TLS is an option here. Yeah, it is. So can ignore that one. ng-http again. And that comes back round to boost. Tempted actually to install boost and reinstall it after ICU has been reinstalled. Because I don't know if there's anything in ICU that boosts need for certain. So I think that would be a good start. It'll certainly help break into this circle, keep on going around here. So yeah, I'm gonna do that. That'd be a good way to go. It's got very few dependencies as well, so that helps. So let's get this downloading. Assume that's downloaded already, is it? Looks like it has, that was quick. Makes me wonder if it's a web page that I've downloaded or not. Let's have a look. Yeah, it is. Okay. So I need to open this up in a new tab. Okay, now it's come up. Save file. Get rid of this tab now. Okay, so I'll extract this. Just looking about the tests, I'm guessing if I get the same number of tests passing, and I will run both sets of tests, even though one takes an extremely long time, I guess it indicates that I don't need to rebuild this after ICU's been rebuilt. So that would be a good indication. If it does go through complete, then I guess that would mean it doesn't need to. With those figures there, 154 tests, I think that would indicate that it's unnecessary to rebuild Boost. Okay, I'm going to run these commands separately and time them, because this looks like this might take a while to build this package. Okay, so that looks like that's worked. Then we've got this command to build it, and we can specify the number of jobs in it. So again, I'll do time, paste it in, then replace the brackets in. There's a 4. And wait for that to build. I guess it's going to be a few minutes. Okay, that's completed. So let's now run the test, and the first set run with this command. It says all 154 should pass. So I'm going to time this. There's several commands here. Okay, so that has mentioned only 154 tests. 153, whereas the book mentions that there's 154. So I'm not going to test the run the extended test, but I will reinstall Boost after it's got ICU reinstalled in case that one test is something related to ICU. So I'm going to install this now. Okay, that's installed, so I've marked it off as needing to be reinstalled after ICU has been reinstalled. So I'll get rid of that and tidy up.